welcome to episode 7, the third last season.
Oh, episode rather.
Oh, sorry, I was doing the spring cleaning.
Yes, he likes to do his cleaning. We're here in the Vatican City because, of course, Saint Mother, what's her name? Mary MacKillop.
Mary MacKillop got sainted!
She got sainted. She's a canon now.
A canon? I like canons.
She was canonized. She's a good old canon now, which is always nice. So much as always, we've got the Gopher count of 90 already, cumulatively.
Oh, am I meant to talk now, Andrew?
If you like,
Hello, welcome to Vatican City.
Clinton is on the news today. Sarah Palin.
Is she? Oh, well, look, we're going to get to that, Anthony Moran, yeah, because
so
that
much.
Is
Jesus,
just shits and giggles, and there's a swear word. Oh, we're in the Vatican City. I'm not meant to swear. Blessed Father for all out there. Oh,
Ben's going to be dancing today as well, which is going to be fun.
Hi, Benedict. How are you? Yeah, I apologise. Blessed Father. Yes, I have sinned. I'm on air.
What
sorry.
Did you say?
That was pokey. I'm not allowed to swear. I'm in his home, country, so it's... But as Anthony
yeah,
Cox,
sorry, Pedro.
Huge here in Vatican City. Look, we just thought we'd pop in, say hello.
Basically.
We had some extra frequent flyer miles coming out from India. So we thought, we'll pop in, say hello, see what the fuss is about. And good old St. Mary Mac. And, She's a saint now, so it's great, and it's all religious. It's so religious here. I walked down the street and somebody walked up to me and was like, bless you, and I'm like, I didn't sneeze.
That happened to me. And
I'm like,
do you have a handkerchief or something? And I said, no.
And then what did you say, Anthony Moran?
I said, well, have a good day,
and then,
Padre.
And then what else did you say?
I said, bless you too, blessed be thee. Holy Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Is the theme of this whole city in the Vatican.
Bobsled be thy name.
Yeah.
If you're a Cool Runnings fan, you'll get that reference. But everywhere you go, Anthony, it's religion. And the other day, I was walking down the street. I'm like, I'm going to walk down the street here in Vatican City.
You walked down the street.
There's only one, because this is like the smallest country in the world. My house is bigger than this country. That's how small it is. But I was so funny. Like, you see the Pope mobile drive around. It's just sort of, you see it everywhere you go here. It's like seeing a Turan or in Gagebrook. But the other day when I was walking down the street, he obviously needed to get petrol. Take a look at this footage. This is the Pope pulling in to get petrol. Look at him. He might be saving a couple of dollars a litre there. He should have gone down to the United. Look at him there, pulling up
what
there.
What is he doing? Like, seriously, like the Pope Mobile, come on.
Well, you've got to get petrol. The Pope Mobile doesn't run on faith alone. Apparently, when we had the Pope on the show...
Well, it did.
Oh, so did
can't
I.
Can't he pray for a full tank?
When we had...
Jesus.
Quite literally.
Yes.
But when we had him on the show the other year, he said it ran on the faith of his believers, so
he
must be lying.
Can we just go to... let's get a quick live shot to the Vatican St. Peter's Square,
Look at all the people. This is them actually worshipping us.
There it is. You would think from afar, looking up in that little window there, that that's the Pope, but in fact, that's me.
This is us. This is right
and,
there.
And Ben's right next to me there. He's somewhere there. Oh, there he is.
The faith that these people have for us, it's just... that was a bit too much.
Yeah, I think it was.
Hello?
Benedict?
Yep, alright. I'm allowed to yell in the Vatican City. He's very persistent.
I call him Florentine. It's an in-joke that we have, hey, Benedict and then ex-Florentine. It's an in-joke and it's very funny because he laughs in German.
He likes being in-jokes. That's an in-joke of myself. Ow. Anthony, when you play a game, when you're in a game show,
yes.
When you're actually sort of, you're in the heat of the moment, you've got to say words really quickly. There are certain words that you should or shouldn't say. Now, this was an example of a US game show, Family Feud, I believe it was, and she was asked a question about naming something about a body part that gets bigger when you're, when you're older or smaller when you're older. I think the one to watch out here is the reaction of the host. Let's take a look at this.
Name a part of your body that's bigger than it was when you were 16.
Your penis.
Thank you.
medical terminology.
I don't care what you said. I said ding-ling, winky, any damn thing. What the hell? It ain't gonna sound right. The medical term is almost worse. A slang term would at least be your ding-a-ling something. The penis.
Oh. Anthony, you don't say penis on TV! Now, I'm excited. Let's get straight into it. Julie Gillard, how are you? Welcome to This Week. Hello, boys! Hello, Anthony!
Hey, Julia. How's the... You're meeting David Bartlett, but you're in a different room. You're in different rooms right now for this press conference, aren't you both?
Oh, yes. Hello, Anthony. Hello, boys. Hello, Ben. Yes, no, look, I am outside here. David's inside making me a cuppa. I took a couple of biscuits last week, but look, no, we're sorting out our differences. Hello, boys. Hello, Anthony. Yes, and moving forward. And Ben, how are you? I'm good, Julia. Thank you for asking. She's quite happy this morning.
She's very hyperactive. Have you had your medication today, Julia?
Oh, hi, boys. Hello, Anthony. Yes, no, look, I did. It was good. It's exciting. I like it. It's good. And my blessed father, Mary McKillop, she's an Australian icon, a woman for the ages, and moving forward. All right. Thank you, Julia. David Bartlett. David, thank you for joining us as well. How are you this week?
Yes, hello, and thank you for having me. I'm very excited, as you can tell by my tone of voice, and I'm confident that we'll get everything we need from Julia Gillard, the Honourable Prime Minister of Australia, and she'll be eating from my bowl of food.
Oh, look, that's very exciting. Look, we don't have a lot of time, but, you know, just each of you, your thoughts on Mary McKillop. Julia, we've already heard a bit of you. David Bartlett, what are your thoughts on Mary McKillop and us being in the Vatican City?
Yeah, been there myself plenty of times. It's nothing to flash, I must say. It's good on Mary McKillop. Pity we didn't have any Tasmanian saints made today.
Well, apparently, obviously, you need to have two miracles recognised. David, have you yourself had any miracles you could be sainted?
Well, I'm a miracle myself, you see, because I am David Bartlett. So,
good point. There you go. Good point, Anthony Moran. He is David Bartlett. And you want to ask Julia something before we get rid of him?
Look, Julia, I just want to know one thing. As an atheist, what do you think about this whole Mary McKillop stuff?
Oh, boys, hello, Anthony. Look, couldn't give a fuck.
Oh, right. Julia.
Cutting.
Julia Gillard.
We told him if they swear, they're off. Thank you very much.
Yes, all right.
Yeah, it's for you. It's for you.
Benedict, hello. Oh, sorry. It's Mary McKillop. She's looking at me from above. Oh. Yes, Mary Maria. Yes, I suppose that's what they call you over there now that you're living over there, isn't it? No, I guess. Well, no, I didn't dance. No, I thank you. See, no. All right.
That'd be gross.
Yes, all right. All right.
Keep the phone calls quick. We're on a long distance here. Yep, she's gone. You're right. That phone call tastes like crap.
She goes on.
She does, doesn't she? Yeah. Swear count's like up the roof. The Gopher count is on 90. Given this is our second last episode, and I'm like a fish. We need to make the 100th next week. So, 5 quick gophers. Okay, 95. That gives us 95 out there, 100 next week. This is, oh, hang on a minute, we've got two things to go. Oh, God, I'm running through the roof.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. What would Josh say?
Well, one thing that I've been looking at in the news lately is this Mumbai terrorist attack.
He said that. And, Soapy's recap.
Soapy's recap.
Yes, awesome. Now, in Home and Away, they're not allowed to swear, but somebody, Rick, I think his name was, this is him, and I don't think he really did swear, but it sounds like he does.
And that changed things for you?
Well, yeah, it made me realise that you'd moved on like you said you would. I just felt like an idiot.
Holy God! Now, I'm going to put that off the hook because I don't want you to ring us. That's rude. We'll be back next week. I don't know where from for a live... It's still ringing. How is that ringing?
It's a Vatican phone, Ben. It's godly.
Catholic. We're going to go. Is that all right with you? Yeah, okay. Look, we're just...
Vatican City!
We'll see you next week on episode 8, the final episode of season 3. The Pope wants to say hello. And, Anthony...
As always, Ben.
Goodbye, I'm gonna slide out. Shot. Bye.